Is in his holy place. God who unites those who dwell in his house, he himself gives might and strength to his people. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, once again, what I would like to say, I'm sure that follow me, you, thanks to God for this wonderful place, especially what you remember that this week was like stronger restriction, what you have to remember about this stronger restriction, these guidelines, it means especially keep this distance between us, and if we treat our place as a public place, it's like obligation to use mask, but for sure, keep this distance, but it's important. And we have to pray. We have to pray, ask God for his grace, especially for his wisdom. What we can see in the readings today, that Solomon, as a good example to each of us, ask God for wisdom, for God's wisdom, for understanding heart. If we try to be open for God's gifts, because God is ready to give to us his gifts anytime, but we have to open our heart and mind. Just remember this and use God's gift in our lives. On the beginning on this Eucharist, what we serve this Mass for Dick Kish, what is intention for this Mass, we look in our heart and mind and find what was not good and tell this moment to God, sorry for our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, Only Begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
The first reading is a reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king, to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for an understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now, and after you, there will come no one equal to you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm will be, "Lord, I love your commands."
Lord, I love your commands.
I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord, I love your commands.
Let your kindness comfort me according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight.
Lord, I love your commands.
For I love your commands more than gold, however fine. For in all your precepts I go forward, every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your words sheds light, giving understanding to the simple.
Lord, I love your commands.
The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects fish of every kind. When it is full, they haul it ashore and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things? They answered, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. The Gospel of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, what I mentioned at the beginning, today's reading is concentrating about wisdom, especially God's view. Try imagine, what will you answer when you hear question from God, questions what Solomon today heard? Ask something of me and I will give it to you. I think this is important moment if we have to answer. And what we know, God gives Solomon an incredible gift, the freedom to have exactly what he asks for. And with that freedom, Solomon asks for something that pleases God. He asks for an understanding heart. Solomon, who knows the ways of God and is faithful to him, is already wise in his own ways. We know that he was, as a young man, really wise. Yet, rather than increase his own stature, he seeks to honor God as the source of that wisdom. He gives glory to God by acknowledging his reliance upon him. But also, if we look in Solomon's history, in Solomon we can see our human nature. We can see that our nature is not perfect. We know that Solomon was a wise man. He was a good king, famous. But not most of his life, what he used his wisdom, not exactly in any time he was really close to God. Without this wisdom what he received, without many gifts, we know that some part of his life was really far from perfect. It means we don't have a monopoly for God's wisdom. We have to be open permanently and ask God for his gifts and cooperate with his gifts. What we can see, a similar expression of freedom is exhibited by the individuals in today's gospel parables. Because also gospel is about wisdom, about treasure, which one we want to use. Here the freedom is found in the desire to experience the kingdom of heaven, what Jesus said. There is sort of irony present, though. In a certain sense, the person who digs for the treasure already owned the treasure underneath his feet. Likewise, the merchant who buys the pearl of great price already had the wealth with which to purchase it. Both of these parables teach us that we desire the kingdom of heaven because we already know it. It means we can use some treasure to hire or much value treasure. It means God's gift. And brothers and sisters, what we have this example in the readings, like this youth, because Solomon was really youth in his time, what he asked God for this opening heart and wisdom. And like this parables, this people who find these pearls and find this treasure. They had before some pearl and treasure, and Solomon also was wise as a young man. But using gift what they had, they asked God for much value treasure, much value pearl, and much value wisdom. It means for us this is an example, because we receive gifts from God. We receive His grace, we receive faith, but we have to use God's gifts, His wisdom, and His grace, that we like accumulate and find much value, higher treasure, higher gifts from God. It means almost like each day we have to be open, because God wants to show to us His sign in many different situations. We have to find this. And God asks us if we are open by our mind and heart for His wisdom, for His gifts. And we have to use these gifts, God's gifts, to decide sometimes that we have to resignate from something and go to the higher. It means we have to choose some situation in our life. This way, we need this God wisdom, God understanding heart exactly. Brothers and sisters, for wisdom, also called from Latin prudence, is the virtue that guides all other virtues. It means to open one door, for this wisdom, first gift, we can open another door if we cooperate with God. And grounds finally this wisdom judgment. The wise seek God, and those who know Him seek to know Him more, as Solomon and the man from parables demonstrate. Just ask God for His wisdom and use it. Amen. Please stand up and to say our creed. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Striving to lead lives that bear witness to God's kingdom, we offer our prayers and petitions to our Almighty Father.
For the Church of Christ and all who dwell within her, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our national and local civil servants and for all who assist them in their governance, may God grant them wisdom and understanding hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who grieve the loss of a loved one who died from the effects of the coronavirus, may God console them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us and our communities of families and friends, may God grant us courage and guide our words as we share our faith with those we meet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, the infirm, the lonely, and those who don't have anyone to pray for them this evening. Remember those committed to our parish list of the sick, and also Gary as well. That God continue to receive them and they experienced his loving and saving power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. Pray for the souls of the faithful departed. Remember Dick Kish, for whom this Mass is offered, that he and all our beloved dead may be welcomed into the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our bishop-elect, Edward Malec, that as he takes the control of the Diocese of Cleveland, he continues to keep us faithful to the Lord and guide us in how we should pray. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those prayers we hold within the silence of our minds and our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear these prayers that we voice to you and answer them according to your will, who has this through your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
A humble spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice and sacrifice be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hand, and praise the Lord in his name.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Especially remember the Kish, for whom we pray at this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Christopher, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to one another a simple gesture of peace.
Lamb of God, you
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
body of Christ. The body of
Christ. Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. 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 The body of Christ.
Amen.
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 The body of Christ.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just again, same thanks that are joining for this special Mass, because finally, girl is okay, so that he could drive to home, naturally, so because it was behind you. But pray for his health, and pray for each other, because we never know what happened. Pray, brothers and sisters, for wisdom, that we can be open for God's wisdom and use this wisdom in our daily life. Use common sense also. Pray for each other, help each other, and keep some rules, because if somebody is afraid, we have to honor other people and help each other also. You can take bulletin traditionally both sides of this small wall, and if you have an extra papering packet, please thank you for donation, for collection, for the support to our parish. And just remind you, each weekend, if weather is okay, we serve mass outside, because lots of people send email, call each weekend, outside, inside. Anytime, if weather be under 97, it means temperature and no rain, we will serve mass here outside, because it's nice, nice place. And this time, each year, we celebrate St. Christopher feast. St. Christopher is patron of drivers, travelers, people. I have a special blessing, and before, because normally we bless each year cars, but now we can't use like holy water, touch, everything. Just, I think, the same power what we use this blessing, and we pray for each travelers, maybe, because we have a few pictures of St. Christopher and some prayer. If somebody has a new car, not blessed last year, you can take this special picture, especially if they are from last year, it's enough quarantine. Enough long. At first, say our once again Hail Mary for any traveler, person, and drivers, also for girl who just drove to his home from this place. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. O Lord, we humbly ask you to give your almighty protection to all travelers. Accept our fervent and sincere prayers that through your great power and unfaltering spirit, those who travel may reach their destination safe and sound. Grant your divine guidance and infinite wisdom to all who operate automobiles, trains, planes, boats, bicycles, tractors, and any other. Inspire them with due sense of duty and knowledge, and help them guide those entrusted in their care to complete their travel safely. We thank you, O Lord, for your great mercy and unending love to all mankind, and for extending your arm of protection to all travelers. Saint Christopher, holy patron of travelers, protect us and lead us safely to our destiny. Amen. Amen. May Almighty God bless each of you. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
No, I'm our tradition, especially from Deacon Joe. Yeah.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thanks be to God.